What's going on, everybody? This is Brian Mazique, aka Unique Mazique, the hardest working man in sports and gaming, and I am pleased to do this video right now. If you have not heard, if you don't follow me on Twitter, maybe don't follow Ronnie2K or Chris Manning, LD2K, you may not have heard the news. And if you don't follow Razor himself, you may not have heard this news. But Razor, the person that I have been working with for the Ultimate Legends roster, my opinion, the best modder out there in the 2K universe, has been hired by 2K to work on NBA 2K20. And I'm trying to tell y'all, like, just listen to what I'm saying. Like, over the past year, and I tweeted this out a little bit earlier, like yesterday or day before yesterday. Over the past year, like, the dude has been like, he's become more like a little brother to me. You know, we talk all the time. Not as much lately as before, but we talk fairly regularly. And you know, this whole process of doing this roster was a long thing, and it was a lot of work on both our sides. Like, he did all of that work, all of that artwork, all making all of those faces and stuff like that. And at times it was tedious and all of that. I did all of those things with the ratings. I didn't really like skimp with any ratings, any singular players. I did the best I could with all of that. But without a question, there's no way in the world that it could have gotten done without Razor's talent. And one of my main focuses, and I told him this from the beginning, when we first started this project, one of my main focus areas was that I wanted other people, especially 2K, to see his talent, to see how good he was at this game. It's how good he was at, you know, his art and recreating these faces and operating and working on this medium. And it feels so good to see him get that recognition, for him to have a dream realized. Like, you know, he would probably tell you himself that there were times that he really didn't ever think that something like this could happen, working in this space, doing something that he loved to do, that he was pretty much doing for a hobby. Somebody would actually pay him to do it, you know. Like, and if you think about it, like, me and Razor couldn't be more different, you know, really couldn't be more different. I'm a near mid 40s African-American man, and he's in the early 20s Lithuanian man. But the common denominator in the whole thing is basketball and 2K. And I love, you know, being of any assistance that I could be to anybody, you know, all the time. And just to see him get this opportunity is great. So I wrote an article on Forbes about this, about how I think that without a question, you're going to see improved legend renders in NBA 2K20. But I want to caution y'all, because I've been seeing a lot of tweets and a lot of stuff coming out since the announcement was made. A lot of people may not have a good grasp on what all it is he can affect. He's not making the game. He's not doing anything on all these other parts of the game. So people are like, I hope down now. I saw one tweet that said, I hope now that means we're going to get Rasheed Wallace. Razor don't have anything to do with whether or not 2K has the license to use Rasheed Wallace's render or his likeness. He has nothing to do with that. Razor essentially is more than likely just going to make the faces of the players that 2K asked him to make. That's about it. It's not probably not going to go much further than that. So if they don't have the license to use somebody, they just don't have the license to use somebody, and he won't be able to make them. You got to understand, 2K's legends, the players that they had and didn't have in the game, it wasn't because, oh, their art department wasn't talented enough to draw these players and now Razor had to come and do it. No, it wasn't that. What it was either they didn't have the license to use and still don't have the license to bring the player in, and even though they're adding new licenses all the time, or they had an old render of the player in the game and they hadn't had the resources, the time resources, to send people from the art department out and say, oh, fix the face for Sean Elliott, fix the face for this person or that person, and they just hadn't gotten to it. But when they saw RZOR's work and they saw how good it was, then now it's like, wow, we can go and employ this very talented gentleman to fill these gaps that we had in this whole process. Not to mention the fact that when they notice and see how talented he is, it would not shock me if he were brought on and just started to work with other aspects of the game, other aspects in terms of other artistic aspects of the game. So whatever the case, whatever this turns out to be, I am just so proud of RZOR for sticking through our project, and the just doing something great, you know. And I'm hoping that people can look at what he has accomplished just from his, you know, and he has much more that he can do, much more that he will do. But if you look, if you're a modder or if you're somebody who is just passionate about a thing, you know, and maybe there isn't a direct career path for it that you know of, like right now, maybe there isn't, but if you can look at what RZOR they've been able to attain and accomplish in a very, in a relatively short period of time, strictly off of his talent and his passion for an aspect of a mega business, this is what he's done. It, there's something out there for you to do with this same thing, you know, or with a similar kind of an interest, a similar kind of a passion. And like I said, man, I'm telling you, I couldn't be more happy for him, more proud of him, very, very just honored to have him, you know, mention me and say that I helped him or anything to that effect. But for me, honestly, it's about helping people and really giving God the glory, because without God placing me in a position to be able to have a platform that I can connect with somebody on the other side of the world. Like literally connect with somebody on the other side of the world. And while there's a time difference, man, we sit here and I'll sit here and I have a conversation with him, you know, through Google Hangout, and we just talking, you know, and he like, hey, this is on my mind, this is on my mind, this is on my mind. And I'm talking to him, man. And it's, you know, all this came, you know, off the strength of basketball and off the strength of the 2K, you know, this relationship that has been built. And this literally turned into something, you know. And you might look back at him, oh, they were just making a roster or da da. Man, it can't. It's turned into so much more than that. It's turned into so much more than that. And like I said, man, I'm really just very proud of him, and can't wait to see what happens in NBA 2K20. What he affects, what he, you know, what he improves in the game. I'm gonna tell y'all, when this dude is really locked in and he is going hard like I know he's doing and has done with this 2K20 project, he works insanely hard, actually a little too hard sometimes, so he needs to pull back. So I know that whatever he touches will be of the highest possible quality. I have 100% confidence in that, so I can't wait to see what it is. And like I said, I'm just super proud of him. So I appreciate y'all watching as always. Hope y'all got a good opportunity to look and see some of this stuff that he's already done. And I'm thinking that that's what you can expect in 2K20 from the renders that he touches. God bless and peace.
How could I be weak? I'm rather unique.